Alright, hello and welcome everyone here to the JDL America Season 1. We've got a best of two coming at you. The teams, they're going to be top 5 going up against Union Gaming. I'm your host for today, Heliumbrella. This should be a pretty exciting game. I had the chance to cast both of these teams, and it should be the most recent face-off that they had, which was the SIVO Grand Finals. That was January 30th. It was pretty one-sided. I see that the betting on joinDOTA as well as Dota 2 Lounge have top 5 favored, maybe the slightly more well-known team, but it's Union Gaming that absolutely ran over them in the finals over there at SIVO. So Union Gaming took home $750 for that. Top 5 took home $250, so not bad, but it goes to show you that Union Gaming, who I like to call the professional Peruvians, are definitely that. They're pretty solid. And taking a look at the bans as we get them rolling here, it looks like the first ban is going to be over to Union Gaming. Their second ban now, they take out the Bristleback, and I've taken some notes. I've actually prepared. I went over the picks and bans from those SIVO finals. Looking at Union Gaming, they do like to ban out the Bristleback. They banned him out in both games. They did win the finals 2-0, so Union Gaming banning out Bristleback first seems to be what they do most commonly. Other bans that they took out in that series were Slark and Alchemist in the first round, but Alchemist already taken out, so Union Gaming, if they're going to follow their trends of their bans, they would look to take out the Slark, maybe even the Timbersaw here. Pretty common first round bans. The last time these two teams faced off against each other, they weren't concerned about a team picking up the Death Prophet or a team picking up a Pugna and that Death Ball push. So actually Union Gaming, they will take out the OD in the first round, just not wanting to play against it. Don't want to give it to Fly, I suppose, who normally is the mid laner, but sometimes we do see him in the solo safe lane or even in the tri lanes as top 5. There we go. They've done their research. They didn't even have to do the research because they got manhandled by Citadel's Dragon Knight in those SIVO finals. So Dragon Knight banned out here. Definitely a quality hero. Seems to be very strong right now. Pretty safe pick for the mid lane. You get to level 16 with a couple items and, well, you've got that cleave, the blue dragon. Pretty hard to stop. And Citadel, as well as some of the other South American teams, such as Smash Gaming, that's not the team name. Swag Iron Tiger, but, you know, Smash Gaming. As well as Lelouch v. Britannia. That's from Swag Iron Tiger. Smash is for Sweet Revenge, which they are playing later in the JDL. I'm not sure if anyone will be casting it because, of course, here in America, it is the Super Bowl Sunday. So, I don't know. Might watch the Super Bowl. Might cast Dota. It's yet to be determined if anyone's going to be covering that game. But if you happen to speak Portuguese or Spanish, I'm sure there's going to be a lot of people covering that in those languages. Looking at top 5 though, their picks coming out, they've got the Enchantress first, and then Storm Spirit pick up second. Looking at top 5's picks, in game 1 in the SIVO Finals, they did go with that Enchantress as their first pick. So they definitely like those micro heroes that can start the push, they can be aggressive in the jungle, and Enchantress, if the game goes late enough and she does well enough, can even transfer into a carry role with the Ag's Impetus. It can do quite a bit of damage, and it is pure damage as Union Gaming, I don't even know if we mentioned their pick or not, but they go with the Visage first. They're looking to play very aggressive. They're a very aggressive team. If I had to use one word to describe them, it would be aggressive. So the Visage gets that done with the Soul Assumption. Grave Chill, slight nerfs to the mana costs. I think he maybe took a move speed hit too. Forgive me if I make some 6.8 patch note errors. I've gone over them, but there's a lot to digest and just remember on the fly. So, we should be pretty good, but Visage, the Grave Chill definitely did get adjusted. Used to have a scaling mana cost, now of course it is a flat 100 instead of going 70, 80, 90, 100. So, I don't know, it's not too bad. Mana intensive hero in the early stages, needing to spam out the Soul Assumption. Grave Chill was cheaper, now it's not. Union Gaming though, they're going to pick up that Nature's Prophet as their second pick. And looking back at their previous games, is that a hero that they like to run? Yes, it is. In game 2 of the SIVO Finals, they actually went with that Nature's Prophet as their first pick, and then a DK as their second pick. So they like to get that push, the ability to take towers. Of course, Nature's Prophet has that global teleport, can be involved in any engagement, and whenever Top 5 thinks they've got an even fight, Nature's Prophet can show up and get it done. Should be played by, I want to say Angel is going to be handling the Nature's Prophet. Still working on getting everyone's roles down, but Ben Jazz here, the captain, as well as the carry that one role for Union Gaming, so still yet to see his hero. Xander should be on the Visage, I believe. Sidorol, of course, is in the mid lane, and Gosu Rei going to be another support. It should be mentioned that Gosu Rei plays one hell of a Sand King, which, you know, got that buff to the Sandstorm that increased radius at level 1, and of course it's everybody's favorite song, so we'll see if that gets picked up. I'm actually hoping it does. They have been known to run the Visage Sand King combination. Nice stun, one of the best level 1 stuns in the game, and then Visage, of course, with all that burst damage. Should be enough to take anybody down as some more bans come out. Clockwork going to be dropped out as a potential offlane candidate for top 5. Pretty common ban, very strong in the offlane still, and can get it done in the mid game rotating around with the hookshot as top 5. They ban out the Puck. Nice mid hero, good teamfight control presence with potential big silences, the dream coil, and, well, Puck gets enough levels and a blink dagger or some treads, tank up a little bit, becomes very elusive and hard to bring down, especially in the current metagame, which is pretty lacking in the stuns, more so just in disables overall, which is also why Storm Spirit has really come back into the scene. I'm sure everyone is pretty aware of this, but Storm Spirit, pretty popular these days. Shout out to Blitz. I have actually had the opportunity to cast Zephyr a couple times in the FDL Season 3 finals, but I haven't got to cast Blitz playing the Storm Spirit yet, but it should be a fly on that Storm Spirit tonight. As we see, okay, another good offlaner band out there. That Bounty Hunter taken out. Just an invisible hero, of course, that can get the jump on Nature's Prophet. And, you know, if you're making trades and teamfight trades, Union Gaming likes to be aggressive. So if they're being aggressive taking towers and trading maybe kills, then you don't want the other team to have a track and be able to stay ahead of you even with the tower gold you're getting in those trades. And Bounty Hunter is just a strong offlane, able to get it done in the mid-game. His rotation isn't maybe as abrupt as Clockwork, hooking in into your face, but able to get those tracks out to a couple heroes in every kill that you get really adds up, and I think he's a great offlaner. He's not great at stopping push, which is, I don't know, it's kind of like a double-edged sword. You can get a Bounty Hunter against a pushing lineup, but you're going to need to be extremely aggressive and get really far ahead with those tracks to stay in the game. Otherwise, Bounty Hunter, not going to help you out at all when the push is coming in to your racks. As Pugna gets banned out, so top 5, they take that out. It did receive some bans the last time these teams played. Top 5 actually did ban it out. Looking at Union Gaming, did they ever touch that hero in a ban? It doesn't look like it, but they have been banning the Lone Druid as well as the Luna. So some of those heroes that can also be strong carries as well as get the push started, as top 5 is going to be allowed to pick up a Timbersaw, and that should be played by Wrong in the offlane. Maybe the solo safe, depending on how top 5 wants to use the Enchantress, just in the jungle farming up, or maybe go aggressive in the jungle and try to get some kills here, as Crystal Maiden going to be picked up third there by Union Gaming. I see someone way too punk there in the stream chats, and by the way, if you guys are watching in-game, should be pretty obvious what the stream is because of what I titled the broadcast channel, but I'd love to have you over on twitch.tv/joinDOTA community. Where I'll be covering along with Mott, Coddle Guy, Capitalist might show up here, or on Join Dota Red to cover the JDL America Season 1. So expect to hear more from us. But for now, you just got me, and I'm Helium, casting this game for you tonight. But yes, I don't think I got to the point here. Night Stalker for Sidorol. It's a hero he does like, and, you know, the nighttime change every 4 minutes. Pretty strong for that hero. Alright, waiting for top 5. Now Rubick going to be picked up, so really strong defensive support there, and of course gets better as the game goes later, able to steal any abilities, whether it be Familiar, Soul Assumption, the Frostbite, the Crystal Nova. Nature's Prophet, not the best person to steal from. I guess getting the ult would be pretty nice, or the Treant even, get the push going. As Templar Assassin going to be picked up, so unfortunately we won't be seeing the Sidorol Night Stalker, but we're going to have the Templar Assassin in the mid lane, probably played by Sidorol.
Five seconds remaining.
Alright, waiting on the fifth ban now from Top 5. Looking at Union Gaming, what do they need? They've got their offlaner, they need a core role, they need a Benjazz hero, and I wouldn't be... maybe it's a little too many melees in the right-click damage department, but Benjazz does like to pick up that Lifestealer. It's not going to be great versus Storm Spirit or Timbersaw. They could use a stun, and actually they're going to ban out the Lifestealer themselves, not wanting to hand it over to Top 5. So I think a carry with a stun here might not be bad. They could potentially go for a Luna just to get the push going with the Nature's Prophet. Maybe Sven? I don't know. Sven got some buffs. I can't quite remember what they are, but I know he did. I don't know. A stun wouldn't be bad, but Union Gaming might be able to just run at them with the TA, Crystal Maiden, and the Visage.
10 seconds remaining.
Viper. So Top 5, they go with the Viper. This is a hero they have been known to pick up. They had it in Game 1 the last time these two teams met. Did they pick it up again after that? It doesn't look like it. But it's definitely a strong semi-carry. And looking at Top 5, they don't really have many carries. They've got Storm Spirit with a pick-off potential to get ahead early. Timbersaw as well. Lots of magic damage, so Chakram should be able to take off Refraction from TA pretty quickly if he can land it. And then Viper as well, same thing. All the damage over time, able to eat away at the Refraction from the Templar Assassin. So it's going to be a pretty hard matchup in the mid lane. I'm surprised maybe the Viper could have been banned over the Lifestealer if you've already picked up the TA and want to run it mid, as Benjazz going to come out with the Juggernaut. Another big ultimate. Definitely a hero that has carry potential. Going to help out on the push as well with the Healing Ward with all the Treants. Good armor reduction here from the TA, but still a little worried that Storm Spirit as well as the Timbersaw might not be able to be locked down, especially with all the slow coming out from Viper, going to be played by Zahn. And Fly looks like he will be going back into the mid lane where he normally belongs. They've been switching up the roles a little bit on Top 5, but Fly is primarily their mid player, so it's nice to see him back in that role again. And of course, we're going to have a bit of a pause. It's not official Dota if there's not a pause. So of course, there's going to be a bit of a pause. Let's take a look at the betting statistics here from the Dota 2 lounge. We've got... Oh, did I lose my screen here? Let's find it back. I think it was 56% for Top 5 the last time I checked. 56, which means about 44% for Union Gaming, which, I don't know, those people might be disappointed. Union Gaming, not only did they just beat Top 5 out in the SIVO Finals, Union Gaming was also the team that knocked Top 5 into the lower bracket in the first place, and both of those were sweeping 2-0 victories in a best of three, so Union Gaming looking to replicate that here. Of course, the format of the JDL Americas is just a best of two. That sort of more European-style format, as it looks like Visage here is kind of logged out of the game, disconnected, so waiting for Xander. And let me double-check my camera settings. It seems really fast. As I get prompted to buy the ticket, you guys should actually buy the ticket, because 100% of the ticket cost goes back into the prize pool of the JDL. Which will be really nice. If it gets to $5,000, then, well, that's great. If it doesn't get to $5,000, then joinDOTA is prepared to just get it to $5,000, adding in any money that is required. So a decent prize pool here for some of these, I guess, semi-pro teams in the Americas League. Maybe a lot of Tier 2 quality teams. I guess Sad Boys and Liquid being the Tier 1 teams if we want to get really traditional. However, the JDL European League is, you know, boasting some bigger names, mostly Tier 1, some Tier 2 teams, but a good way to build up the league and get some prize money out to the teams that are, you know, looking to expand and looking to get better. As, yes, minimap drawing practice, very, very good skill. If you want to get better at Dota, you should learn to draw on the minimap very well. Looking at joinDOTA, our very own betting service here, which I believe is just for points. I don't really use it. I'm not too into gambling, to be honest. But that's got Top 5 at 55.3%. So about 55% Union Gaming at 35.47%, which you might say that doesn't add to 100%. There's, I guess, 9.2% of people that are undecided. Guessing that's what the third category is. Oh, no, it's win, tie, loss. Okay, so 9.22% of people say that it's going to be a 1-1 at the end of the best of two series, whereas 55% say top 5 2-0s, and Union Gaming, they've got about 36% support saying that they will win 2-0. As I'm not sure what we're drawing here. Hopefully this game can get started up pretty soon. The other game for today in the Join Dota League America, that's going to be Swag Ein Tiger, the Brazilian team going up against Four Sweet Revenge, also a Peruvian team. So I could be looking forward to that later. I'm not sure that I'll be covering it. Maybe someone will, but I mentioned it a little bit earlier on the draft. It is Super Bowl Sunday today, so I don't know. Might be watching the Super Bowl. Not that I'm a Seahawks or a Denver Broncos fan, but, you know, Seattle is where Valve is, so you kind of got to like the Seahawks a little bit if you play Dota. And then, of course, Peyton Manning, it's hard not to like that guy. So we'll see what happens in the Super Bowl, as it looks like finally, as we're starting to drift on a tangent, the game will be on the pause, so good timing, I would say. To introduce the teams on the dire, top five, the favorite team in this matchup, at least in terms of the community, but I've got my money on Union Gaming. We'll see how it goes. Shanks going to be on that Enchantress. Looks like they're going to go scout out the lanes, maybe just a defensive jungling Enchantress here. We've got Zon Zon Zon, or Fight Fight Fight, on the Viper here, going into probably the mid... No, it looks like he will be just in the top lane, backed up here by D. DD Crush, I believe, is what his name is. Teacher D, top five on the Rubick. We've got Wrong on the Timbersaw, and it's going to be Fly on that Swarm Spirit. Heading into the mid lane, maybe he'll stay top. The Viper will go mid. I would assume they want the Viper going up against the Templar Assassin, but that rounds off top five's lineup. Over to the Radiant, we've got Benjazz leading the charge here with that Blade Fury. He's on the Juggernaut, of course, Gosu Rei. I'm hoping we get to see a Sand King at some point in this series, but for this game, he's on the Crystal Maiden. Xander Steel behind him on the Visage, and it looks like they're not really gonna run into each other, but a nice lane ward being thrown down for some vision. Over to the mid lane, it will be Citadel on the Templar Assassin. Probably the player to watch here for the Peruvians Union Gaming, as it will be Angel on the Nature's Prophet. God, that horn is so loud. Gonna be Angel on the Nature's Prophet here into the off lane, as it looks like, yep, Crystal Maiden Visage. Benjazz as well, a little bit further behind. Gonna be rotating down to the safe lane, so two defensive lanes coming out from both of these teams. Wrong, going to be going down there, and taking a look at Wrong Timbersaw. So Timberchain, of course, a couple weeks ago, months ago, I don't know, time feels like it goes fast. Timberchain was changed, so if you get stunned in the middle of it, you now stop, which went from being extremely OP to still pretty good. There's no stun on the Visage, and, well, pretty much just going to be up to Crystal Maiden to throw the Frostbite mid-Timberchain animation. Otherwise, I think Wrong can get a lot out of this lane down here, and he's likely going to be picking up Timberchain level 1. But it shouldn't really... The Timbersaw being here shouldn't really mess with Benjazz farming all that much. Expect him to get a lot, and as aggressive as Union Gaming is, I expect him to get maybe Phase Drums straight into an Aghanim Scepter, just to get that ultimate online, be able to fight a little bit earlier, as those fireworks are kind of annoying. I don't know. Mid lane, though, Fly. Seems like he's, you know, getting a bit of harassing, holding his own here, throwing out those overload charges onto Citadel. Trying to get that bottle farmed up here. Fly's got quite a bit of regen. Pull two tangos, and Citadel could be in some trouble here. Out of mana. His bottle, though, is already on its way, being delivered by that Donkey Courier. Probably the rarest of all couriers. That's top five using their normal TI3 swag. Should probably ask them. I'm pretty sure they were all there, at least a couple of them were. I think they're a West Coast team, and they seem to have a lot of genuine goods from the international. What's this? Shanks on the Enchantress, which should be noted, one of my favorite heroes, looking to get a gank on to Angel on the Nature's Prophet, but he's playing very defensive, and well, this is wise, being annoying here with that Treant, looking to just pull the lane away. Won't make it, because this Treant's only got 7 seconds, but this wave will then get confused, run around for a little while, and he'll get a double wave pushing at his tower. Which is a good way on Nature's Prophet to just pick up some XP. We'll see when he wants to go jungle, because this isn't the easiest lane. He can get overconfident pretty easy just thinking there's a Viper and a Rubick, and, well, even with those two heroes, I think he can be brought down pretty easily, and there's always a threat of Shanks rotating over and maybe helping pick up the first blood. So Angel, we'll see how long he decides to stay in the offlane. I think going into the jungle wouldn't be all that bad. Viper, what's he going to do? He's basically just going to farm up a quick mechanism. So, I don't know. Viper always bringing a lot of damage pretty early on because of the Nether Toxin, which should be noted, that is physical damage. And he's actually going all Nether Toxin. Even got 1 point in Corrosive Skin, interestingly enough. No poison attack yet. As Shanks, they might try to push this Nature's Prophet behind the tower. Shanks can maybe backstab as we approach 3 minutes. No First Blood yet. Timbersaw, he's up to level 3, so he's doing pretty well. Angel's Nature's Prophet's only about 2.5, so the Timbersaw, in terms of the offlaner, is having a bit better of a time. Except Timbersaw can't really go jungle. Angel does have that choice. It looks like the gank isn't really going to work out. Mid lane, though, Fly in some trouble. Citadel, we saw him bottle that DD rune a little bit earlier. Fly will go down. Citadel drawing up the first blood as the items go out, because, once again, this game is now on the ticket. The first time I cast here on Join Dota community. We didn't have the ticket yet, but it's up, it's operational. Make sure to check it out in the Dota 2 store. As now it looks like just gonna make another rotation back down to the bottom lane, his home. There goes out the Frostbite. Now you can Timber Chain away from this, but Wrong is gonna go in aggressively trying to kill the Crystal Maiden, and that might have been the wrong move. And here comes Angel on the Nature's Prophet, looking to maybe throw a Sprout. Doesn't have it yet, he's only level 3 in this spot, that common hook across. I can't draw down there, but you sort of can. Even with a level 1 hook, if you're put right here, you can hook across as... Wow, I saw that on the minimap, but I didn't expect someone to be that low. The TA going to be taken down by Fly, so it gets a bit of a revenge kill as now Angel in the top lane in some trouble. The Enchant goes out. They're not going to decide to dive, even though they had the Hellbear Smasher to take the tower, worried about the potential TP in by either the Crystal Maiden, who, in Crystal Maiden fashion, is missing off the map right now. Of course, she can just jungle with the Frostbite pretty effectively, get up her levels and stay off the map and, you know, always be a threat. You don't know if she's got a TP or where she is. She could have just been at the Tier 2 tower. So I think it's wise that Top 5 backs off there. But we got ourselves another pause. They've got the Siege Engine up here, Hellbear Smasher. I think this is going to be the time where they can take this Tier 1 tower. Will they be able to push and get down a tier 2? I don't think it's going to be too easy with their lineup, but of course they can try. If they don't, though, just getting this tier 1 tower kind of opens the lane to Nature's Prophet to get a little bit more from the lane. But if they keep pushing, yeah, you know, we've mentioned it enough. He can jungle. Let's take a look at the farm. We'll start with Benjaz, as he's leading 23-4 on the last hit to Night Shark. But here comes Angel, still not level 4. One more creep dice, he's going to get his Sprout. That can open things up. Shanks may be baiting a little bit, but the lift onto Angel. Angel could be in some trouble. No one gonna do anything. There's the Sprout. They're gonna get Rubick. Here comes Visage. Has Grave Chill. 2 points in. Soul Assumption needs to throw it if he wants it. They don't have to. Gonna try to maybe get another one here. Are they gonna get any? This could have been a mistake to not use that ability, but Angel gonna pick up an assist. Benjaz even TP'd up. He's the one that's gonna get the kill there, as Xander's will find Shanks just chilling in the jungle. 1 point in touchable, so a little slow. Here's Gosu Ray rotating through the enemy jungle with quite a backstab. So Union Gaming out ahead at 2 kills, 3-1 early on. And of course there was that trade in the mid lane. Oh, big Psyblade hit from the meld in the mid lane. 1-1 on the TA, 1-1 on Fly. In terms of the creep score, we've got 26-6. So it's actually Citadel leading that. He was the recipient of the first blood as well. But Fly not doing bad either. 23-1. Gonna have a big impact this game, that's for sure. And Timbersaw kind of left to his own devices as well, so he's reaping some benefits, some more levels. He's almost got his Chakram online here at just 5.5 minutes. Only 11-2 on the CS charts. It's not incredible, but it's not bad given he was in a 1v3 lane. As Rubick, he's up to level 3. Shanks as well. Let's see, between them, no more wards yet. No working towards an urn early, which you might see an Enchantress do. I think they want to gank, but look at this. TA with the traps everywhere, spotting out the rotations of these supports. So Citadel playing this mid lane very, very nicely. None on the runes yet, but Crystal Maiden, Citadel looking to get into a fight. The Dire, though, they've got a nice defensive ward up here on their high ground. So they're spotting out Gosu Ray as he tries to roll around the map. He's got a ward looking to place it, I would assume. Citadel picks up treads after the bottle and expects him to go maybe a blink after this, but I would expect more so a Yasha into a quick BKB. He's gonna need it because Storm Spirit, as we've noted, flies doing pretty well. Oh, actually, he's gonna pick up a kill on the Crystal Maiden here. Gonna get jumped on and melt almost immediately. Xander as well, in some trouble. He will go down on the backside of things. Sidorall will pick off the Ruby. He's got a trap to use if he needs to escape, and he will fly. Got a bit of mana to chase that, as well as the double damage rune, but that's two kills quickly in the mid lane. Is it a double kill for Fly? It is, so he's gonna be 3-1-0. And why the BKB would be a good pickup for the TA is definitely Fly gonna have an impact this game. He's gonna have a decent time to maybe 15 to 17 minute Orchid. And he's gonna be able to get a lot of kills with that if there's not a BKB. He'll be able to just focus out the TA, and they don't want that. He could even be in a bit of trouble here. Lucky for Sidorall, though, he doesn't go down. He picks up a kill of his own in that in exchange. It's definitely better for top 5, but it's not terrible that the semi-carry, or even the carry Templar Assassin in the mid lane, gets a kill and gets away. Angel back down, actually, not back down, into the bottom lane for the first time, going up against, well, besides the gank he ran a little bit. He shows up against the Timbersaw. Timbersaw hates trees, and I don't know if it was planned or what, but he lands very well against Nature's Prophet, who is in a bit of trouble. Fly TP's down. He doesn't have an overload shot. Now they're not going to be able to clean it up wrong. Pretty much fresh out of mana. Fly the same. I think he's going to have to run back to base, and it looks like there's a gank potential here in the middle lane. Top 5. The Rubick in trouble. Teacher D going to be going down. Juggernaut going to spin to win. Pick that up with the Blade Fury. Medallion of Courage. Now, this is an item that's very, very powerful. Maybe one of the more broken items at the current moment, especially after Necronomicon taking those hits that it did. The bounty, the armor reduction, four spirits as well. Not that that was an item, but whatever. I think Medallion is maybe the next item that will be looked at. It's really, really strong right now, and they don't really have... I'm surprised. They do have Visage that normally gets the Medallion, but Sidorall picks it up first with the farm he has, some more armor, some mana regen, but gonna be pulled back by Fly. Sidorall in trouble, the poison attack coming out. Nice ultimate by Benjez, though, melts Fly immediately, locked in the cage match, but lucky for top 5, there's no mana for the Blade Fury. Now there is. He's gonna go on to Shanks. Shanks the heal, just rank 1, not quite enough. Double kill for Benjez here, as Sidorall connects with a nice meld shot, dishing out the damage, but it's Benjez who gets the kill. So 7-3 for Union Gaming, and as you guys can see, if this is the first time you've witnessed Union Gaming, they do like that aggression, and at 9 minutes in, we've already got 10 kills in this game. And a decent amount of farm at 9 minutes with this much action. 44 CS for the Templar Assassin, 41 for Juggernaut Fly. He's fallen off a little bit because of mainly that one failed rotation to the bot lane where they could have killed Angel, but he's at 31 CS. And I'm surprised that Zon on the Viper doesn't have a bit more. He was in the safe lane, but he's 33-6 at the moment. Angel, he's got the phase boots up right now, another 1200 gold as he looks to pick up, you know, the common phase Midas build. And if you get that any time before 15 minutes, I think you're doing pretty well. 10 is ideal, 15 is maybe you think about not going for it, so he should get it around 12. Actually, maybe he just bought something. What did he get? Okay, he got the Gloves of Haste, so he's about 800 gold away from that. Not actually doing math, just a ballpark. It is, what, 1550 now for the Midas recipe? Maybe 1500, not sure. I've only bought it a few times since the recent change. That was 6.79C though, I believe. But hold that thought, it's going to be Angel TPing up top, looking to get a Sprout onto somebody to set things up. 30 seconds on the Omni Slash, and this is maybe where Union Gaming could be too aggressive. They need to be careful to wait on that. It's a really nice ability. It was what took out... Wow, okay, or if you set up with a two-man Sprout, but Tango's still on the field right now, so they eat out of that. Shanks pops the heal, but still just level 1. 20 seconds on this Omni Slash. Here comes Wrong now. The Chakram doing a lot of damage on the backside of things, though. I think it's going to be Sidorall and Visage that take out the Viper. Sidorall going to meld up. The tower drops, but it doesn't matter. They throw the Chakram and the Remnants on top of him. Xander's going to TP out, and so far the trade's 1-for-1. The Viper, safe lane farmer for Sidorall's TA in the mid lane. They might still get the Crystal Maiden here. A Sprout goes out, but Timbersaw does not care about trees. Well, he does, but they disappear. There's the ultimate finally up, gonna spin to win, gets one, but will go down. Wrong gets the double kill, so a nice good rotation from him. The first time he's got involved in a big team fight. Angel fighting to the last breath, and I don't think that was quite necessary. Will Teacher D go down? Oh, that guy right there. He pays the price, and I think that heal might have just come off cooldown. It is a pretty long cooldown at 45 seconds, but at the end of the day, I think it's... Is it a complete? I think the Visage got out, so maybe 4-4-3. So top five, they lose their tower, they lose three, but they kill four players from Union Gaming. So a pretty even trade. Xander's almost takes off Shanks there. I think he could have got a couple more attacks in with the familiars, and he might be going down here in the wrong place at the wrong time. We'll see how many puns we can make with wrong on the Timbersaw here. Looks to get the kill with the Chakram. So he's 3-1-1. Visage as well, picking up a medallion. And we talked about that earlier. TA got one pretty quickly. Not the most common item on her, but it does make sense with Meld reducing armor as well. Holding that thought though. Fly gonna melt Angel and the Nature's Prophet. So top five, they're up to 9 kills. One more, and it's gonna even at 10-10. Citadel should be the next casualty. Melds up. Do they have any detection? They don't actually have any detection. So Citadel throws out the melt hit, looks to fight once more. Fly is now completely out of mana. I think Citadel is going to turn this around. He will turn around. Can he get Zon? Also completely out of mana. The tower is going to say no, but Citadel turns that 2v1 engagement around on top five. The aggressors in that circumstance, but it's 11-9, 2-kill advantage for Union Gaming. Going to get another tower, so all the tier 1s on the map have dropped. Looking at top 5's towers, they've only been able to push down that top tier 1, which they got pretty early going against the Nature's Prophet. But the CS hasn't changed much. TA pulling ahead, 62. Ben Jazz on the Juggernaut at 49, and then 38-38 apiece on the Viper, on the Storm Spirit. But switching to net worth now, we're about 13 minutes in. Pretty much the same story there. Angel doing maybe a little better than you might think. Getting some towers, you know, some assists. 1, 2, and 7, so he's third in net worth at 4.4k, and above him are his own teammates, so that's a pretty good place to find yourself. TA at 6.3k, the Juggernaut Benjaz at 5.6. Poor Rubik down there at the bottom where Rubik tends to find himself. Playing that 5 role, I suppose. Yeah, definitely, if you got that Enchantress jungling, gonna be, you know, in the 4 position. She picks up the Urn, so that's pretty expected item choice from the Enchantress. You like to fight early, you need some mana regen, and one of the biggest problems with Enchantress is that she's extremely squishy, so Urn of Shadow is going to give you some effective HP, and can also fit offensively. Ultimate onto Zon. Benjaz, he's still not quite level 11, so no rank 2 ultimate, and we can see that the level 1 Omni Slash has already been pretty effective in getting 6 more, or 3 more jumps rather. The heal goes out onto Angel, moving the healing ward, but there's too much burst damage. Xander in a bit of trouble, Crystal Maiden trying to turn things around, but Teacher D has stolen the Blade Fury. Citadel though running in, 6 charges on Refraction of the tower, gonna dissuade him a little bit. Omni Slash has been used. The last fight that didn't have Omni Slash at the start was also in the top lane, and it didn't really favor Union Gaming, so they might want to just back off of this and just wait it out another 90 seconds as the Yasha looks to be completed on Benjaz. So FaZe Drums was correct. He goes for the Yasha now. It's nice to have attack speed before going for maybe an Axe, because there's a certain threshold, and don't ask me what it is, but when you get enough attack speed, you're able to auto-attack in between your Omni Slash slashes, so having attack speed before picking up an Axe is a pretty good idea, just to make it that much more effective. And popping a drum charge as well as having a Yasha, I think, might just be enough for that threshold. Don't quote me on that, though. Alright, so the Phase and the Midas is online. I suspect it's been online for a minute or two. We're approaching the 15-minute mark now, so Angel's got what he needs on time. And with the Belt of Strength in the inventory, despite the nerfs to the Necronomicon, we can suspect that Angel will be going for that, definitely. When you're aggressive, something you gotta do is break the high ground at around maybe 25-30 minutes, and the Necronomicon, that aura, is really gonna help with that. It's also nice on Nature's Prophet, because you can just run that Terran dropship. Just throw your Marines into the other lane. I don't know why I always throw StarCraft references into these casts, but why not? Just teleport to the lane, drop off the Necro, and then leave, and it'll just push out the lane. Now it's maybe not as worth it, because at rank 3, 200 gold apiece. You're feeding over 400 gold to somebody every time you do that, potentially, so it can be a little risky. The auras are nice for the teamfight as well, so Angel can always just save them and deploy them out when the teamfight gets going. They add attack speed as well, so that's going to help Benjaz with that threshold we talked about on the Omni Slash. But 12 to 10, 16 minutes, still that 2-kill advantage for Union Gaming. Checking out the graphs overall, we suspect Union Gaming to lead in both categories, and it's pretty sizable right now. About 7,000 gold, 2,000 XP, so top 5 still holding on in that category. Union Gaming, they've been grouping a little bit more and winning these fights, but since they're grouping, you know, a little Not quite as far as you would expect to be ahead. Benjaz once again throws out the rank 1 ultimate. Should be enough to get Zon. Visage is going to clean up that one with the Soul Assumption. Sprout onto Shanks. Even the Courier is going to go down. Morrissey the Smeevil on the deck. Able to Blade Fury away as the Rubick with that stolen spell. Xander is going to be jumped on immediately by a Fly. Crystal Maiden throws out the ultimate. Getting a full channel, but didn't really hit everybody for that full amount of time. Benjaz, though, going to spin to win once more. Will get wrong. There's a Sprout onto an ally, not exactly the best. Rubick trying to make the plays with that Freezing Field Rampage, but it's not going to happen. He will be taken down by the double damage Citadel before he gets the chance to really do much damage with the stolen Freezing Field. But another good fight here. That's going to lead to the Necronomicon being completed by Angels Nature's Prophet, and it's 16-11 after that. Not a very good fight for Top 5. I don't know if Union Gaming even lost anybody there, and hopefully no buybacks were forced out from Top 5. No. The graph will tell us here in a little bit. I think it was actually just 4 for nil. And these birds, looks like they are up to rank 2 right now. No, they're not. Okay, apparently they're just level 2. First time I noticed they had a level, to be honest. As we can look at that again. Thought that might indicate they were rank 2, but Visage is not level 11 yet. He's just level 8 right now. Gosu Rei as well, level 8. Actually, looking at the supports, we noticed XP wasn't... There wasn't that big of a difference in XP between the two teams, despite Union Gaming kind of driving in the driver's seat this game. We see TA up there at level 13, so that's a pretty big deal right now. Benjaz finally hits level 11, so the rank 2 Omnislash, it's online. Angel as well. Wrath of Nature is not only good for controlling the lane equilibrium with the creep, but it's pretty big if you throw it in and get those last couple bounces in a team fight onto some heroes. Timbersaw as well, level 11, so the Chakram rank 2. Going to be doing quite a bit if they can't lock him down, but they do have the Juggernaut ultimate to just throw on either the Viper, the Storm Spirit, or the Timbersaw, so that can at least take out one threat pretty quickly, as Viper not having the best game, picking up a pretty late mechanism for being in the safe lane. He's 0-3-6. Zon, though, finally gets the mech at about 18 and a half minutes, and Shanks, level 8 on the Enchantress. It's going to be a long time before he becomes a big threat with the right click. Sure, Impetus is still pretty nice now, but not really going to be a semi-carry threat this game. Unless it goes really, really late, but Union Gaming, of course, they're not looking for that, and it won't be terrible if it does. They do have the Nature's Prophet, and you never really want to go into the late game versus Nature's Prophet if you don't have to. Juggernaut picks up the full Manta style right now. Interesting item choice, to be honest. I guess just to help out with the push. Maybe to break the slow of Viper, but Rong's gonna be jumped on immediately. Ultimate goes out. Rong does already have a Ghost Scepter. He eats quite a few bounces from Benjaz's first rank 2 Omnislash, but the Blade Fury is gonna take it down. Shanks trying to live through this, but he won't be able to. Benjaz is gonna get pulled in. There throws out the Manta, gonna send his illusions to do his bidding. Zon will go down. They're getting killed on their own doorstep. Angel TPing very aggressively, gonna take out the Rubick, and now Fly, the last one alive for Top 5, will be sprouted. He's got enough mana to escape, and he will. And this tier 3 tower, they can't even attack it yet. The tier 2 still stands, and Union Gaming is diving into the base of Top 5. And Union Gaming, I guess, looking for the upset here, for those of you that maybe haven't watched the two teams play. Because in terms of some of the betting websites, joinDOTA's in-house betting system as well, Top 5 was favored slightly for these matchups, but recent history has Union Gaming walking all over Top 5, and once again here in Game 1, that looks to be the case. This is just a best of two series, so hopefully Top 5 can put up... Well, this game, of course, isn't over, but maybe more of a fight. Draft potentially a little differently, starting off for Game 2. Not that their draft is bad. Their draft, I think, is actually pretty terrifying. They've got three really strong heroes that need to be dealt with in teamfights, but with Benjaz, he loves this Juggernaut. He also likes to play that Lifestealer quite often. The Omnislashes, so far, it's been enough to deal with at least one or even two of those potential damage dealing heroes from Top 5, the Viper, the Timber, and the Storm Spirit. And then besides that, Rubick, not a support that is dealing a ton of damage in comparison to this AoE damage on the Crystal Nova, the Frostbite, the potential for a huge Freezing Field. There was a pretty decent one in the last engagement, and then Xander, of course, with Familiars, with the Soul Assumption. He can almost take out the Enchantress or Rubick on his own when the team fight breaks out. That's 21 minutes in. The second tier 2 soon to fall here in the mid lane. I say the second tier two, that maybe seemed redundant, but the first tier two to be taken was in the bottom lane, so top five loses that one. And they're gonna hold on to the mid one for now. Roche was just taken. I probably saw that and just didn't mention it. Yes, Benjazz, they went in there right after they dove and took out that bottom tier two. They take the Roche. Throw the Aegis over to Benjazz, which, I don't know. Once he ults and throws the Blade Fury, there's not much else he's going to do upon respawning. I guess maybe Blade Fury, if it comes off the cooldown, and TP out. But I think it could have been better suited on the TA. She's actually more of a right-click threat right now. Eh, maybe not with the crit potential of Blade Dance. But with the armor reduction of Medallion, with Melds, I think she could maybe respawn and just kill somebody really quickly instead of just escape. Shouldn't really matter, though. I'm not convinced that either of those heroes are really going to die in the next fight here. We do have top 5, though. Smoking up, not giving up, looking for a pickoff. Maybe going to claim their second tower of the game. This could, though, be pretty easily defended by Unigaming if they want to. They might just go for the trade in the mid lane. Trying to take out the tier 2. Where's Benjazz? He's up top. Split pushing in the top lane. 2,600 gold on him. We'll see what his next item is going to be. I think Aghanim's here is still going to be pretty good. Wrong in a bit of trouble. Medallion gets thrown out. The Glyph of Fortification going to be used. 3 TPs coming in immediately. And this is one of the biggest changes in 6.8. That when multiple people TP, they get there a little bit quicker than last time. So teams can be a bit more responsive to dives or pushes. Which is pretty nice. Meanwhile, Citadel's not there, so Union Gaming may not want to fight this. Citadel just chipping away at that top tier 2 tower. Should be able to get it while Union Gaming, they just siege up in the mid lane. They will take out the mid tier 2, so now they could dive, but they're not going to. They're going to stay pretty calm and calculated. Wait for Citadel to farm up a bit more, take out that top tower. He's also got the Treads Yasha and the BKB online, so that was a pretty expected item choice, item progression, after you see the Treads first. And he's also going to be going for the Manta right now. Just get more bodies on the field and push away. Manta illusions here for Benjazz and Citadel pretty soon. He's actually got enough money to finish it right now. Or maybe the recipe is a little bit more. I thought it was 900. I don't know. I don't build Manta. I don't usually get to get a Manta on my supports. But the ultimate from Benjazz. He's going to take out the Rubick immediately. Does quite a bit of damage to Fly. He's not going to be able to really re-engage on that. Shanks has the heal. Popped out Zon. Going to be focused down. Goes down immediately. Citadel with the BKB. Still slowed by the Viper Strike Corrosive Skin. But it doesn't matter. They just walk in to top 5. Benjazz will go down, but he does have the Aegis. Wrong, the only one to live. Buyback here by Fly. Soul Assumption Wrong dies in his own fountain. Fly on the Storm Spirit buys back, but just by himself. Not going to be able to really do anything at only 24 minutes. And there's the Manta going to be completed up on the TA. The Tier 3 tower in the top lane has fallen, and the Rack's going to follow suit. All Tier 2 towers are down, so Unigaming can potentially get the Megas here, or maybe one more lane of Rack's. Let's see who's leaving. It's going to be Visage TPing into the bottom lane right now. So that's their mechanism. Another Medallion going to be departing. I'm not really sure why. I guess to just start pushing out the bottom lane. It's kind of low on mana. I don't know how much he would have really done. As look at that. Finally, they get that Manta illusion. Took quite a few hits from Zon's Viper. So the Tier 3 tower in the mid lane falls. The Rax in the top lane is no longer as the creep. You know, taking out those Econ buildings. Adequately named building. I don't know. They could use something more creative. I know a lot of people have mentioned that, but maybe one that we can only dream. Roshan? This was a long timer. Actually, not really. It's about a 10-minute Rosh. So let's back up, as we can see, in 4 minutes, 15 seconds, and we'd expect Union Gaming to be all over that, but if top 5 maybe want to get back into this game, they could smoke, get a pickoff, or just smoke and take out the Roshan pretty quickly. But looking at their right-click damage, they really can't do Rosh quickly, so that's going to be really hard. They definitely need a pickoff and maybe winning a team fight, and they're kind of in an awkward situation that they really just need towers and some potential map control. So even if they win the team fights, they might want to just go for push over sneaking a Roche. And I don't know, at this point, I don't know if they can win the team fight with the Aegis or not, but it gives them more of a fighting chance. At least denies the Aegis from Union Gaming. Radiant's middle tower is under attack. So the Necro 3 is done on Angel. Not a big surprise there. Benjo's not even going to go for the Ags. Gonna go for that butterfly. He's got the Eagle Song picked up already, and he's very, very close to purchasing up the butterfly. Couple hundred gold. Fly there. Should be pretty scared about this. He could maybe bait out an Omni Slash and buy some more, I guess, farming time. Omni Slash, he's thinking about it. But there is that Invis rune on Fly. I'm not sure if Benjaz maybe clicked on him and scouted it out. Do they have any detection right now? Checking out the Visage, they don't. So Fly can maybe extend this play a little bit. Gonna be... doesn't even want to use it. He does use it finally. I think he was fine escaping with the ball lightning, but uses the Invis anyways, as there's an Ag Scepter. I expected to see at least one this game as Xander picks up the Ags, gets that sixth man on the field in the form of three familiar shanks. Gonna be jumped on very, very aggressively by the Crystal Maiden, picking up the Blink Dagger. Nice ultimate by Benjaz, the Ghost Scepter though, to save Rong's life. The tier 3 is gone, the Rax already being focused. Sidoral with a bit of a wasted BKB charge there, as Angel is actually going to disconnect, but I don't know if it's going to matter too much. Freezing Field out, I guess, just to zone. Whoa! Whoa! It's like in 3D. Look at that ice crystal. Kind of badass. Wow. I'm spending a lot of time on this. Yeah, that's cool. Anyways, ulting here is Gosu Rei on the Crystal Maiden, just I guess putting a bit of a buffer. Where's Angel, actually? We're gonna leave the awesome Ice Crystal. You know, he's DC'd, so he's just running back to base. He's got 2,180 gold, and checking in on the gold graph. We haven't in a while, although we could have expected this. 25,000 gold advantage right now for Union Gaming, about a 20,000 experience advantage, and this push into the mid lane could be the final fight of the game. We found another Ice Crystal, by the way. This one could be even cooler than the previous Ice Crystal. I really wish you could use, I don't know what it's called, Showcase View as a broadcaster, but you get this beautiful error message, which is unfortunate. I guess they don't want us casting from point of view. That could be a little disorienting, maybe? I don't know. It would be cool for moments like this. It should be allowed during pauses. Now that would be awesome. I think that is a good idea. But here is the go. Wrong gives the go-ahead. Angel gonna be running back here. The mid Rax has already fallen. The Freezing Field used, I think, pretty much just for the lulls right there. And there's only one Rax, and maybe even just a throne if Unigaming wants to force the issue even quicker, standing between them taking this first game and in a best of two series versus Top 5. And hopefully, I mean, Top 5 is a quality team, and they're very, very good. They even played well in the games versus E-Hug. But I think Union Gaming just has their number. Every time I see them play Union Gaming, it looks like Top 5 just can't get it done. It's, I don't know, it's interesting. Definitely a rivalry here in the Americas scene. As the final push maybe coming along here. About 28 seconds on the Necronomicon, because of course that cooldown is a lot longer now as well. Tempestall going to deal with the trees, which have turned out to be a pretty good disable in this game. Benjaz, again, the Omni Slash, another 30-second cooldown, so I think Union Gaming might want to just wait for everything to be up. Roche actually respawns in about a minute, so they could even back off and do that, just to be very, very cautious and make sure to win this game cleanly. You know, you don't want to get sloppy. It's a bad way to play the game, to be ahead and then just get really sloppy at the end. It's good for a team to play extremely serious and, you know, to a T the entire game. Even in games like this, when you find yourself at a big, big advantage. I don't know what this pinging is for. They're gonna smoke up into this, actually. I think Angel TP's on the backside. He's actually has a BKB right now. The ultimate from Benjaz will go off, so everything is online. Healing Ward is even gonna be dropped. Fly gonna take it out immediately. Benjaz, though, chasing them into the base. Should be able to get one of them, if not both. Blade Fearing away was the Rubick as well. Ghost Ray could be into trouble. Could be the only casualty of this fight, but won't be. I don't know, it's getting pretty close. Wrong, though, will be brought down. The GG was already called during that, as the prizes go out and is indeed a glorious victory for Union Gaming. They win this by about 30,000 gold, maybe 20,000 some XP advantage. 30-11. The early game was maybe pretty even, with Fly getting off to a good start on the Storm Spirit, but Sidoral and crew, especially Benjaz, on point with the ultimate, just getting it done. And we'll be bringing you game 2 shortly. And also, you can follow me on Twitter at Heliumbrella. I'd love to have you follow me, as casting now for the JDL Americas fairly regularly here on twitch.tv/joinDOTA community, so make sure to give the channel a follow. as well.